Hey, everybody. You might be looking at the title, and this might be a few days late, maybe not. But you might be looking at the title and seeing something like there called 9/11, Where Were You, or in this case, Where Was I? And you know, it's kind of hard to believe that it's been 10 years since that occurred. But I will always remember where I was. And I remember distinctly just waking up early in the morning. It was about 2001. I was going on four months working at Burger King, my first full-time part-time job I ever had. And I just remember getting ready to go to work that afternoon. I mean, I had started out, when I started working now as an opener, I would get up early in the morning, stuff like that, but as time went on, they decided to put me later on in the afternoon when they needed me, or when they would have the most people. And I remember waking up that morning just so I could have a couple of hours to myself before I went to work. And I remember switching on the television, just flipping through the channels, and I came up to, I think it was Fox News, the Fox News channel, and I saw part of the World Trade Center burning. I think it was the North Tower. And I thought at first it was just, you know, a building, because I wasn't really familiar that much with the World Trade Center. Believe it or not, I wasn't. You know, I really wasn't familiar with some of the big skyscraping buildings there. But I just watched it, and I'm thinking, I wonder if this is on the other news. And I check, ABC has it, CBS had it, NBC had it, Fox News, of course, on the syndicated Fox stations had it. And I'm thinking, well, and I'm hearing, you know, like everybody else, that a plane must have crashed into it, but I wasn't sure if it was like, you know, like anybody else, I wasn't sure if it was just an accident or what happened. And later on, I'm just watching, and I think I'm flipping through the channel, see if they get any more information, if anybody knows any more. And I think it's while I'm flipping through the channels that the second plane came crashing in. And I'm like, holy shit. And only then when I watch this, and only then did I know that this was probably no accident. No, not probably, but this was definitely no accident. And it was definitely confirmed to me when I was watching the news that this was no accident. And I called, and believe it or not, nobody in my family, I think at the time, not even my dad, who lived about 30 miles away from where I did, knew about it. He didn't know about it. And I called up my family out here to see if they knew anything. I could not get a hold of my mom because I think she was getting ready for work, or she just left for work or something like that. And I called my aunt, one of my aunts, and I told her to turn on the news. And she turned on the news, and she couldn't believe what she was seeing. And I think that's how my mom found out. I think my mom also found out through my sisters and stuff, but it was just, it was shocking. And I think she also found out when she got to work that something had happened. And I remember calling my dad and said, "Dad, turn on the news. You're not going to believe what I'm seeing, you know, what has happened." I told him. He turned on the news, and I think it was around this time when he turned it on that the Pentagon was crashed into as well. And it was after I told who I knew and my family what had happened that a little after that, that the plane in Shanksville crashed in Shanksville. And all I remember is I knew right off the bat, like I said, after the second plane crashed, that this was no accident. That this is bad. This is not good. And watching on the news and watching what the president had to say, and having everybody confirm, all the news channels confirmed that this was indeed an attack, a terrorist attack, and who could be behind it? It just pissed me off. I mean, I was just pissed off. I was angry. And I remember going to work that day, and we had this one guy, this kind of Indian-like guy, Indian guy, that if you looked at him, you would almost mistake him as being Islamic. Almost. And I just remember, you know, going there, and I'm just walking to work, and I'm just pissed, and I'm looking at this guy, and I think this guy that worked with us, who I think started about a month after I did, kind of, I think he, it's just my opinion, but I believe that he knew a lot of people weren't going to be really nice to him, nice around him for a while, because they weren't sure of, you know, where he stood in all this. Because of, you know, again, the way he looked and everything, because he looked like he could pass for Islamic, it really, or whatever. You know, just really, you know, he just really, I think he felt the tension from everybody. I mean, everybody, I'm pretty sure, I truly believe that a lot of people knew that he probably didn't condone this, that he was against it as well. But for that day, and I think for the first few days, he kind of, there was a little bit of tension towards him. Because he was very, if I remember correctly, and I'm probably wrong, but if I remember correctly, at least for that day, he was silent. He didn't say a word. And everybody, the one thing everybody was talking about at work was, you know, we got to get, let's focus on our job, let's do what we have to do, take care of these customers. All the customers came in, the thing that was on their minds was what happened that day, and the same thing was on all our minds, so. But again, I just remember being pissed off, and angry, and I just remember turning on the news and just standing there in shock, you know, like I couldn't believe what was happening. And again, like I said, I was just pissed off, didn't like what I was seeing, and you know, the only justification about that is that even though it took about 10 years, you know, we got the son of a bitch behind it. I mean, at least we got one of them. And that's Bin Laden. At least we got his ass. And his ass is now grassed. But, you know, in the past few years, you know, I've been hearing some members out of my family, like my teenage nephew, he's been saying that, you know, there might be more behind it, that government may have been behind it or something. I hear that on the news, these documentaries, and it's like I told my mom, we'll never really know the truth. We don't know if they were behind it in some ways, or if it was truly an all-out terrorist attack. We don't really know. But I firmly stand behind the fact that it was an all-out terrorist attack. And again, the only justification, even though I know it doesn't bring much closure, it doesn't bring, even though I know it brings some closure to the victims' families, the only justification in my mind is right now is that we got Bin Laden, we got his ass, and that whoever is taking his place, well, that guy's next. Whoever's trying to take his place as being the next Bin Laden, that guy's next. So, that's all I could say. Well, all I can say now is, you know, like I said, I can definitely remember where I was, and that's all I'm going to say about it. And my heart and prayers and thoughts go out to the families of the victims, to the brave men and women that gave their lives, you know, the firefighters, the policemen, those on Flight 93, United 93, you know, my prayers and thoughts go out to all the victims' families, you know. You guys will always be in our hearts, and that's all I can say for now. But on 9/11, 2001, where I was at home getting ready for work when this all occurred.